where he is. He might be having a nice swim somewhere in one of his swimming pools. We know that Rishi Sunak is one of the richest MPs in Parliament, if not the richest MP. And he has made the political decision to cut the £20 uplift to Universal Credit. We know that that uplift was really just an acknowledgement that the social security system for both those people who are in work and having their wages subsidised, their low pay subsidised, and those people who are out of work or who cannot work, it was just an acknowledgement really that the social security system has been cut to the bone, that it does not allow people to live a life that is not just filled with stress and worry and anguish over the bills, over the brown envelopes from the DWP. There is so much anxiety and worry bundled up into that department. And for this man, one of the wealthiest people in the country, the richest people in Parliament, to make that cut is despicable. We are absolutely ashamed of our government. They do not represent us. They do not represent working class people. And they use the language of liberation, don't they? That we want to get people into work. People receiving this benefit are in work. Yeah. They are working as hard as they can. They want to avoid, they want to obscure what is actually happening to the system, that low pay is endemic, that work is insecure and precarious, and that is a really complex and broken social security system. So workers in Unite, people who are working, care about people who are unemployed. We care about people who cannot work. This is about working class solidarity, knowing that in this system, any one of us are a few decisions away from poverty. Any one of us are a few really difficult, catastrophic life circumstances away from not being able to work. Any one of us can experience poverty in our lifetime when we do not have access to wealth and we do not have access to power. And you know what? I think sometimes people say that these people do not really know what it's like to live in poverty. And I get that sentiment. Maybe they don't. Maybe they represent more affluent areas. Maybe they represent and are so kind of shielded by their own wealth and privilege. But I actually, and Richard Bergen said this in Parliament this week, I actually think that's a bit of an excuse. I think they know exactly what this means to working class people, this cut. I think they know exactly the pain. And no matter how much we tell them, no matter how much we reveal of the pain and the suffering and the trauma that their system is causing to working class people in the United Kingdom, they still do it, don't they? They still go ahead with it. People stood up in Parliament this week. You have all given interviews, you've campaigned, you've protested, and they still make the cut. Why do they make the cut? Because they do not represent us. They represent their own political interests. They represent the idea that only a few should have wealth and power and everything else is a mere inconvenience. And what they will respond to, maybe not us constantly telling them about the trauma that they are inflicting our communities, but pressure. Them knowing that actually hundreds of thousands of people in the United Kingdom actually feel like we do, not like they do. We care, our communities care. It's a nonsense that we're all out for ourselves. Working class solidarity exists, and this today, your campaign, all of our campaigns, be it in Unite the Union, which is a powerful and brilliant trade union, or any of the other movement groups, this is just the very start, isn't it? We will not ease up the pressure on this Tory government when they continue to inflict pain on our community. So Rishi Sunak, you might not be here today, but we will come back and we will protest and we will keep protesting about the pain that you inflict. You do not represent us. We want you to keep the £20 in place. Workers, unemployed workers, disabled workers want you to keep the £20 in place. Do not make the cut. Thank you. Yeah.